Hello friends, in the last video we have discussed about position of Fermi level in n-type. We have seen it is above the center or it is near the conduction band, or we can say it is between donor energy level and conduction band. But what is the exact position of Fermi level? That we have to derive the equation. And I think we have started the equation and we have come up to equation 1. So let us revise the equation. We have seen it. The number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of energy levels in conduction band and into probability. So probability, we know f of Ec, it is a standard Fermi Dirac distribution equation. And we know Ec minus Ef is much more than kT, it is several kT. So this one we neglect, and so we get 1 upon exponential Ec minus Ef by kT, or we can say it is exponential Ef minus Ec by kT. So again we use this equation, number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of energy levels into probability. So this is number of energy levels, it is 2 into 2 pi m star kt upon h square raised to 3 by 2. We know m star, it is effective mass, and this is the probability exponential Ef minus Ec by kt. It is the equation 1. I hope this is the derivation, very important derivation, and I hope you are writing with me. So be ready with your pen and notebook. Okay. So this is number of electrons in conduction band. Now this must be equal to number of ionized donors. Now again we come to this diagram. See, this is the donor energy level, we know. Now when one phosphorus atom is ionized, how many electrons are given to conduction band? Yes, correct. It is only one. When one phosphorus atom is ionized or it loses the electron, it gives one electron in the conduction band. So can we say that number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of ionized donors? I'll repeat the sentence. Number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of ionized donor. Okay. Now donor is ionized means what? For example, phosphorus. Phosphorus is ionized means phosphorus loses the electron. So when it loses the electron, does it mean its energy level is unoccupied? Okay, its energy level is unoccupied. Now when one phosphorus atom is ionized, we get only one electron in conduction band, and therefore we say number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of ionized donors. Okay, so number of ionized donors, how to find the number of ionized donors? Okay, so again we use the same equation. Number of ionized donor is number of donor atoms into probability it is unoccupied. Because when donor atom is ionized, it loses the electron. So its energy level is unoccupied. So it is Nd into 1 minus f of Ed. 1 minus f of Ed is the probability that donor level is unoccupied. Now 1 minus f of Ed, again we reduce, just similar to this equation. This equation is for probability it is occupied, and now we reduce the equation to probability it is unoccupied. It becomes Ed minus Ef by kT. Okay, so this we call equation 2. Please remember, it is for occupied, it is Ef minus Ec by kT. And it is for unoccupied, we write Ed minus Ef by kT. So can we equate 1 and 2? Equation 1, number of electrons in conduction band, and equation 2, number of ionized donors. So this must be the same. So we equate equations 1 and 2. Okay. So write your equation. Correct. We get this equation. It is 2 into 2 pi m star kt upon h square raised to 3 by 2 exponential Ef minus Ec by kt. Correct. This is equation 1. and it is equal to equation 2. It is nd exponential ed minus ef by kt. Correct. Okay. Now we want to cancel this exponential term. So see, physics part is over here. This equation we get from physics principle that number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of ionized donors. So hereafter there is only mathematical manipulation. So what you do, we have to solve this equation. Correct, we take the logarithm. So take the logarithm on both the sides. So what we get? Correct. So it is log of this term, log of 2 into 2 pi m star kt upon h square raised to 3 by 2, log of this term, plus exponential and log, we know they cancel each other. So we get e of minus e c by kt is equal to log of nd plus ed minus ef by kt. Correct. Okay. Now we only rearrange the terms. Okay. So we take this log term, log of 2 into 2 pi m star kt upon h square raised to 3 by 2. We take this term to LHS. It will become minus. And we know log of a minus log of b. Is it log of a upon b? Correct. So we use the same here. And so we get the next equation. It is EF minus EC. We multiply by KT. So this KT will get cancelled here. So is equal to KT log of ND upon this term 2 into 2 pi M star KT upon H square raised to 3 by 2. Again, in this term, KT will get cancelled and we get ED minus EF. Correct. Okay. Is it clear what we do? We take the log. So log of this term plus exponential and log, they cancel each other, EF minus EC by KT plus log of ND plus ED minus EF by KT. We take this term to this side, it will become minus or negative. So log of ND minus log of 2 into 2 pi m star KT upon h square is to 3 by 2. It becomes log of ND upon this term. Then we multiply by KT. Okay, now find equation for EF. I will give you some time. You find equation. Just you rearrange the terms and you find equation for EF. Yes, correct. This EF, we take this side, it will become 2EF. This EC, we take to this side, RHS, it will become EC plus ED. Okay, and then we divide by 2. Correct. So we get the final equation like this. It is EF is equal to AD plus EC by 2 plus KT by 2 log of ND upon 2 into 2 pi M star KT upon H square raised to 3 by 2. See, this is the equation for Fermi level in N-type semiconductor. This is equation for Fermi level in N-type. Now consider the situation T equal to 0 degree Kelvin, absolute 0. So if we put T equal to 0, see this whole term will become 0. Okay, and what we get? EF is equal to ED plus EC by 2. So does it mean it is at the center of donor level and conduction band? Correct? It lies midway between donor level and conduction band. Okay, this is the situation at absolute zero. So as we increase the temperature, see this term, see this log of this T raised to 3 by 2. So as we increase T temperature, T here in this factor, T will increase with the power 3 by 2. So this log term will become more and more negative. This term will become negative and obviously EF will decrease, Fermi level will decrease. So what does it mean? It will drop or it will approach the center. Okay, as we increase the temperature, this log term will become negative and Fermi level will decrease or it will drop. So if we increase ND, what is ND? Impurity concentration or donor concentration. If we increase this, correct, this log term will become positive and EF will increase. So can we say it will rise with increase in temperature, it drops, and with increase in impurity concentration, it rises. Correct. Okay, now we write equation for p-type semiconductor. In the same fashion, we write for p-type semiconductor. So the equation is like this: EFP means Fermi level in p-type, EA plus EV. EA means acceptor level, and this is valence band by 2 plus KT by 2 log 2 into 2 pi mh star KT by h square is to 3 by 2 upon Na. Now mh star is effective mass of ore. Again, at t equal to 0, Ea plus Ev by 2 means it is midway between acceptor level and valence band. Now as we increase t, this log term will increase and the Fermi level will rise. And if we increase the impurity concentration, Na, acceptor concentration, this log term will decrease, will become negative, and EF will decrease. Okay, so what is the effect? Do you get the effect? For both n-type and p-type, extrinsic semiconductor, as we increase the temperature, in n-type, Fermi level drops. See the situation, see this diagram. See, this is at 0 degree Kelvin and this is increase in temperature. So in n-type, you see Fermi level decreases, approaches the center. And in p-type also, Fermi level increases and approaches the center. So in one sentence, we can say in extrinsic semiconductor, with increase in temperature, Fermi level approaches the center. And what is the effect of impurity concentration? In n-type, it rises. And in p-type, it drops. So does it mean it moves away from the center? So effect of temperature and impurity concentration are opposite. With increase in temperature, it approaches the center. And with increase in impurity concentration, it moves away from the center. Okay. So this is the Fermi level in extrinsic semiconductor. We have derived the equation for it. Now, what is the effect of temperature in intrinsic semiconductor? See, in intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons is always equal to number of holes. So, it is always at the center independent of temperature. Okay, in intrinsic semiconductor, it is independent of temperature and Fermi level is always at the center. Okay, so this is the derivation for Fermi level in extrinsic semiconductor. Okay, thank you.